to see. And then I would ask everybody to say a pledge.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And then I would ask for a motion to approve the agenda.
I make a motion.
I'll second it.
It's been moved and seconded to approve the agenda. Larry?
Yes.
And Pam?
Yes.
Okay, first thing on the agenda that I want to talk about just a minute is that I am working on the committee. It's a little bit fun to, I want you to know that there's several things I'm trying to do. I'm trying to retain some people that were already on committees to have a continuity that will move us through. And I'm trying to pull in new people. Can you hear me?
No.
Okay, so, I don't.
I forget.
Sorry. There's, and then I want to get new people that have not been out and worked with us before, especially young people who will someday be the leaders of the city and they will have a chance to work on committees and get to know people and get to know the older community and get to know how this government works. I am trying not to load the committees up with one person. Sometimes, you know, we have somebody that does a great job and so we ask them to do everything. So, or we have a couple or one family does a lot and we appreciate all that, but we want to pull more and more people in. So that's why I'm taking a little time. Also remember that I get to nominate them, but the board gets to approve. And so I want input from the board, from the community, from everybody. So if you know people who you think would be really, really good at doing something, let me know. Pick up the phone, call me, send me a text, whatever. I prefer call. Because that way I talk to you longer. one we have set, okay? Our dear Mr. Alan Arns is going to be the chairman of the Economic Development Committee. He's dedicated. He has worked with the city and with different committees for years. He knows people. That's important. And he has worked with people who work with economic development over the years. Do you want to tell who you're going to have, or should we go ahead? Konechki, Dustin, and Larry Cook, and then
Evelyn
Henning, and Kalina Ender. And so we have Kalina, the new person that's not been involved. We accomplished that. She's enthusiastic. She's excited. Alan, who's got the experience. Evelyn, as you know, has been involved in lots of things in the city and gives of her time freely and is very organized and helpful, okay? We still will be looking for that economic development administrator, which is a paid position and is dictated by the, the rules of the organization, that we have to have one. They do not have to live in town. This is the position that Linda Webben had years ago and then Charlie had. So that's a position that's there. So again, let me know if you have anybody in mind. Okay, we have the minutes in your packet. We have, and these are online. Kathy got these online today, so all of this packet's online. We have the minutes from the last meeting, and then we amended those in order to designate the signatories on the signatories. signature cards at the banks. They have to have a specific language, so we put that in the minutes. So that they could get their books right, okay?
We did say it at the meeting.
We just didn't have it in the minutes. So it was okay in the motion, not in the minutes, and we amended that to take care of that. But I do need to a motion to approve those amendments.
Do we make motions for both of them, or just the amended?
The amended.
All right, I make the motion to accept the amended city minutes.
I'll second it.
And Pam?
Yes.
And Larry?
Yes.
Okay. The next thing on our agenda is that the council may review the financial statements in November and December, and that may is in there for a reason, because I wasn't sure we were going to be ready for this, but we wanted it to be on the agenda in case we wanted to. Remember that this is a special meeting called primarily to pay bills. Okay? The November financial statements had been prepared. The December have not been prepared. Eddie, who works with QuickBooks, is going to be working with Kathy to get her more acquainted with all of the tools of that QuickBooks program. Marla's been working with her to get, you know, so she understands the entries that have been made and so forth. I talked with Eddie last week, and he said that he was available. He said, let the girls work and get all the knowledge they can, and I'm here to help, okay? Then his assistant, Sonia, I believe is her name, has already set a date, I believe, to come in with the closing tools and so forth. But this is going to help a lot. You have to understand that Eddie is the guy that wrote this program. We can't get anybody better to come in and help us, okay? And by the way, we have prepaid support work, so we still have hours not used. So this conference won't cost us anything, okay? We may need to buy some more, but as of right now, we're ahead of the game. So we're going to move on to the next one, which is indeed the reviewing, approving, and or rejection of all claims presented. We always have that right. If anybody objects, we have to talk. Well, doesn't matter whether we object or not, we need to talk. Everybody needs to know what we're paying. This is the pile of bills, okay? We're kicking this around. I'm just trying to give you a lot of information tonight. We're talking about starting our meetings, of course, at 6:30 is fine, but there's a lot of people that say 6:30 is a little early if they're coming from a job or something. And we're talking about opening the meeting because we want it open to the public, but at the very beginning of the meeting, going through the invoices together, discussions, whatever, so that everybody understands what we're paying. We can vote to approve them later on the agenda, as an agendized item. But then people who can't get here till, say, 7 o'clock or something, they may miss that, but they would have missed the main part of the meeting. So I think that's what we're going to do. We just have a lot of things that we want to implement as we go on, okay? I went through the bills this afternoon. These guys are just getting them.
I got a question.
Okay.
Do we actually know with Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Nebraska, we got an estimate of $2,000. Do we have a solid number?
Yeah. Let me explain that. What happens is that our employees are paid, and correct me if I'm wrong here, the employees are paid every 2 weeks.
Right.
Okay. So we don't meet every 2 weeks. So in order to be able to write that paycheck and do those deductions, we have to have approval ahead of time. So that has been the practice, and Charlie always said that the auditors okayed this, and apparently they did because, you know, several years ago, because it's been going on for a while, that you estimate what the payroll will be, because we never know what overtime, how much snow we're going to get, for example, those kind of things in that second pay period. That Blue Cross and stuff is directly related. They don't take it all out of one paycheck. And
so on this other sheet, it says estimate $2,000.
And then you have an actual
$1,600 is what we paid.
Yeah.
So we're covered at least we have enough money.
Yes, there's enough approved for anything that is an increase or decrease there. So that's always anything that's connected with payrolls, okay?
Okay.
And that would be like their IRAs or anything.
Yeah, I see that.
Okay? Any others?
Now, the questions that I'm going to ask is just because I need to know, I'm not arguing the fact that they need to be paid.
Right.
I just want to know
what they are.
Paid.
Okay.
For instance, the EMC insurance, I see, are we paying that every month? That, is that a premium we pay every month for liability,
right,
and coverage for,
right,
vehicles,
right,
buildings, equipment, et cetera?
The EMC is the big one that covers everything. That's your city insurance. Okay. Blue Cross is, of course, the health. And then you will see, well, where's mine?
Colonial
is the one we just approved recently. We don't, but we'll send the premium in.
Okay.
That's taken out of their paychecks.
Okay.
But the employees pay that for themselves.
Okay.
Okay? So just for the public, if you don't have one, do you all, if you want them, the garbage, the energy, I don't know what that media is. 360 media. What's that?
That's a Nebraska Criminal and Traffic Law Manual book.
Okay, so this is something for the police department. The Blue Cross, Public Power, Rural Water, those are utilities, have to's. This is the way it is. C-Mart. Will be gas and or Cox Auto was a repair for one of the pieces of equipment. They bought something and then the guys fixed it. Talked with Luke there this afternoon.
It's a sewer right there.
Oh, yes.
Sewer.
Well, I think, yeah, okay.
There's a bearing.
A bearing out of one of the equipment. Farm Supply, the Journal, Downtown Auto finally put a battery in the police car and something that some of the, oil change, I think.
Yeah.
The EMC, of course, the insurance, bank card. The credit card is, I'm told, the guys, we send a lot of water tests and so forth in for testing. And they use their credit card at the post office to pay. It's $67.
So who has all the credit cards? Just the two workers, or who?
I think Larry, Luke, and Marla will. Or I mean, Catherine.
Okay.
And they have their own name on them, is that right? And so everything's been canceled for anybody that had one before, and I think it's just three now? Yes. Okay.
So didn't last month or in December we were told the credit card had the Santa Days stuff on it?
Yeah.
So.
Well, that won't happen. So because sometimes what happened was they thought it would, no, it was like easier to pay if they paid it by credit card.
Well, we got into the fall on the Santa Days. I'm just wondering. So there must have been something came in later.
Right, there's several things that came in, like there's another bill that still isn't paid that was with some of the banners around town, but the CCC is supposed to pay that, so it just needs to, I will call them so that they pick that up. And you're always going to have some of that that's
okay.
And that's why we like to do this, so we know. Great Plains, of course, we know. Hendricks Law. We paid through the 15th. That was what we voted to terminate that contract as of the 15th. So that's paid for 1.5 months. Kirk and Michaels is the engineers in Omaha who were working on the sewer plant. Way, way back when, there was an invoice for $6,100, and that included like a whole bunch of their work. I know we talked at the time and I thought that was pretty darn reasonable. But apparently there's 100 and some?
122.
And it just says that there was, I don't know. It's like they paid 90% of it or some dumb thing. So apparently they figured it's all done now, so they billed. So we're paying that off. Okay.
Did we find out if we pay this 122 that we're clean?
We're not done. We'll pay them a lot before
well,
this.
Well,
so, but no, that's paid. Yes, that was pieces paid. And I have been in touch with these people too, and they are setting up meetings. They're going to set up meetings to come out and talk to public or whatever, so we can talk more about the sewer plant. Okay?
Here, this is what it says. Professional engineering services in connection with the planning and improvement. Professional engineering services in connection with the planning and improvement selection of for the wastewater treatment plant in Crofton, Nebraska, per the authorization to proceed, signed September 14th, 2017. That is what this $6,100 had paid for.
That was the initial cost,
yes.
I believe. And I don't know, I have no idea why that 122 was with it, not paid. It was something about a percentage in there. So they probably wanted a percentage to get started, and they figured they're on their way now, so they billed it. Okay, any more questions on that?
No.
Okay. The next one on the list is Sherry Leader, and she had that group in here. They collected so much money for each participant, and then the city got a percentage of that, so there's $15 due Sherry.
Is she going to continue?
I don't know. We haven't heard, have we? She was told that she could continue. I've not heard from her. Leaf is...
Copy.
Yes, that's the new copy machine. It's a lease deal, and I think we pay per copy. We get so many copies, and if we go over that, we have to pay extra. That's the way that goes.
I'm not sure.
I think that's the way it was set up, that you get so many copies out of that each month, but if you go over that, you know, then it's you'd pay extra. It's $60 for the month. That's not bad.
That was just the basic contract payment, $60.02. So there was no extra charge.
There was nothing other charge. And I don't know if there was, if we didn't go over or if that'll be separate. I just know that when we made that deal with them, that was part of it, that we could be charged for copies. Michael Harold is our local locksmith who's trying to get a business going. And, We're paying him $125.52, and we put some new locks on the office. Midwest Laboratories is who we pay for the water, cat, those kind of things. Modern Woodman, that's our IRA accounts. That's connected with payroll. And the Nebraska Auditors of Public Accounts is $1,000. We've been paying $1,000 a month for it seems like forever, but it hasn't been. But we were just talking about that. We'll double check that and see how much is left. But that's for the 2017 audit.
Okay, total is $13,000.
Right.
We pay a portion every month of that.
Looks like we've made 18. This would be number 9.
Well, we have 3,000 or 4,000 left.
Yeah.
That was one of the things that was supposedly an interlocal agreement that we put into the budget somewhere. And because it's between two governmental things, I don't know. But they wouldn't let us do it the second year, and we paid them that almost 50,000 all at once. And then the third year, I think that one's paid too, but it wasn't as much, maybe that's already paid. Public health, environmental lab, that's another one of water and so forth.
Oh, we must join some water association.
Yeah.
Okay.
Is that NRD water?
No, this is an organization at Wahoo, Nebraska. I lived at Wahoo, so I know about this. They've got the cheapest utilities in the state of Nebraska. They really know what they're doing. And apparently this is an organization that they've created, and they let other cities join that, and then they give out information and blah, blah, blah. So there's a whole booklet I was looking at in there. I think it's $15.
$150.
$150.
So this paper on the...
That's a one-year,
We have to fill out this paper for the, that says 2019 on here. Do we have to fill that out every year?
It's a yearly dues.
So we have to fill the paperwork out for it, correct? This looks like an application of membership renewal. So we'll have to fill this out and then send in the...
I think the girls fill that out. We just have to approve it.
I think so.
One office solution is our paper and our copier and stuff. So this is the $158.84. So that 60 or whatever that I said wasn't bad, that's just the lease on the copier. But still, we're looking at our copy machine at $207. There's always arguments about that, which is cheaper, you know, whether you buy the machine. If you buy the machine, you do all the repair. If you don't buy the machine, you know, they keep it running. So I haven't looked at it, so I can't comment.
This is the one that tells you if we've overused copies or whatever.
Okay. So they'll keep us informed. They're a pretty good bunch up there. I think. There's another one. Let's see. No, postmaster, $100. Probably for we do a lot of bill. Mm-hmm. Randy's electric was to fix something on a pole out here for the Christmas lights. Stephen's service, pretty much most of our gas, I believe, goes through there, $1,270. Stephen's Incorporated, $184.32. That's probably...
looks like it was some kind of screen repair.
That was repairing the skid plates on the maintainer.
We have the right to reject. don't put that in there. And then we have the Telebeep Wireless, which is a pager thing, and the Verizon Wireless, $169, and there's three phones on there. Maybe two. No, we looked today, it's three. It's Larry and Luke.
Three participating ones.
Yeah. Larry and Luke and this.
Pat?
No?
Yeah.
Is it Pat? Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. So that's our bills for a total of $31,936.78. So, everybody step up with your checkbook. We'll pay this.
Not deserved.
Any questions? Okay, second page of the claims list continues, and there's your estimated payroll. You might as well do this. So the payroll estimate for December 30th to January 12th, 12,000. The next one is 12. They're about 12,000 pay period. Okay, and then you have the Blue Cross and Blue Shield. That was the 20,000. EMC 41, and then the actual payments. Blue Cross was 1610.51, EMC was 3898.22, and the estimate on the December 2nd to the December 15th. Okay, that was actually 7973, and then you have the taxes and the IRA.
Yeah, I have a question.
Yeah.
Are we doing the January 27th through February 11th because our council meeting is 2 days later?
I looked at those dates myself and I said, okay, what's going on? Do you know anything?
Mm-mm.
I don't either.
Well, I find it unusual that we pay somebody.
Well, we didn't. Yeah, but we didn't pay. We're late in paying bills. That's
okay.
So my understanding is the pay periods go 2 weeks, and they end on a Saturday.
Right.
And we're going to take a look at all this payroll stuff, because then, traditionally, because I did sign checks once already, And they asked me to come into the office and write these like right away on Monday after pay period ended. No company does them that fast. That's like at the end of the day, Saturday, and you got the checks out Sunday or Monday. So we're going to take a look at this about our pay periods. But we will need to pre-approve unless we go on a monthly basis. There's a lot of detail here, so I can't tell you how all that will work. But the guys, the people that work are not going to want to go to a monthly deal. They're just not going to. Now, that doesn't mean they always get what they want. But you know, we'll have to really look. Alan, do you want to say something?
Yeah, is that 12,000 payroll, is that before or after Hendrick?
That's, the Hendricks aren't on this.
Okay.
Yeah. They were separate.
Yeah, they had a separate contract. They were not employees as such. We did not pay withholding nor insurance. Okay. Any other questions?
No.
I would entertain a motion then to approve the bills.
I'll make a motion to pay the bills that are in front of us on the list of 123 and 19.
Together or separate?
Both.
This here. It's 31.
Do all of them. And the payroll.
And the payroll.
Yep.
And the payroll, excuse me.
I second.
Okay, so then let's call on Larry first.
Yes.
And Pam.
Yes.
All right. Is there any other business?
Anybody have any questions?
Concerns? Anything that you want to bring up to us? That we can maybe research before the next meeting in February. Something that's kind of underneath your crawl a little bit. More an old compass.
Okay, then let's entertain a motion to adjourn.
I'll move to adjourn.
I'll second it.
And Pam?
Yes.
And Larry?
Yes.
And so we would adjourn at?